Greetings, Eric Bakker. Thanks for coming back and checking out my videos. We're going to do a series on Pseudomonas Aeruginosa. So we're going to talk about a bacteria that can cause a lot of problems in people. There's not a lot of this information on the internet. You'll find a little bit on Wikipedia or a bit of information on different medical forums, but I've got a bit of clinical experience with Pseudomonas, you know, now working with gut-related disease for many years, and I performed easily 5,000 stool tests now, so thousands of tests. And I'll tell you a bit about Pseudomonas. This bug is a common bacteria. It's found a lot in wet and marshy environments, and it can thrive in all kinds of crazy environments, even like contact lens solutions. And it can be found in resuscitation equipment and medical equipment. It can be found in hot tubs and pools. So it can live in places, you know, the darnest of places. They've even found it in gasoline or fuel. It can live in that. So, and it forms quite an impenetrable, slimy, moldy kind of a layer. So when you go walking out in the bush, you know, go walking somewhere, there's a lot of water, and you see slime or mold sitting there on the surface of the soil, there could well be Pseudomonas actually incorporated into that slime or mold. So this bacteria is found in the human GI tract, but in extremely small amounts. We don't normally really see it in a high growth count in a stool test. But when we do find it there, we find it with other associated factors, which I'll talk about in another video. So it's a commonly occurring bacteria. It's an opportunistic bacteria, meaning it's waiting for the opportune moment, and it can cause serious infection and death. We find it in typically in serious lung cases like cystic fibrosis. We also find it commonly in burns. People have got bad burns all over their body. Also indwelling catheters, so people in wheelchairs or, you know, infirm people. We can't move much, we rely on catheters, you know, they're more prone to getting this kind of bacteria. So that's a bit about Pseudomonas. Check out my other videos and I'll talk a bit more about the signs and symptoms and the treatment, etc. Thank you for watching my video.